wearable technology.
And medical reporter Dina Baer gives us a glimpse.
An oral retainer that operates the computer, a fitness band that tracks breathing. Students dream it, and then they build it. And ultimately, patients benefit.
At the bench, they tinker, solder, and splice.
When your wire goes into the board, make sure it's not shorting into anything else.
This is Wearable Tech, a 400-level course at University of Illinois Chicago, the brainchild of clinical associate professor Hanana Esmail-Beghi.
I always wanted to build devices and contribute to improving the quality of life.
And that's exactly what happens in this lab.
They work together, they develop a wearable device every 2 weeks.
The 32 students, a mix of computer science and biomedical engineering majors, work collaboratively to build 5 different devices over the course of 15 weeks.
In this class, we kind of learn from each other, not just from the professors.
When you see as a result, not only that they learn to work with hardware and the software, but they've also learned to communicate with people from various different backgrounds.
This week's project, fitness bands.
Basically, I'm a computer science major, and we mainly do software stuff. But this semester, I wanted to see how hardware worked and see how that connects to the software side of it.
The devices are sophisticated, incorporating multiple functions in a single band. Built-in sensors measure electrocardio activity, breathing, and heart rate.
So put it further away from the heart, right?
Troubleshooting is my favorite part. That's why I picked engineering, because nothing's going to go right the first way around.
It's meticulous work, hands-on experience in an industry that's exploding.
If the pandemic highlighted anything, it was that our health is really important.
Since the COVID outbreak,
the wearable market actually grew by 23%. We started by counting our steps when it came to wearable tech, something around our wrist maybe, but now we're moving way beyond that.
I really liked the fact that I was able to build technology with my hands, and I liked the fact that wearable technology, like the impact that wearable technology has in our everyday lives.
Graduate student Veronica Brotland took the wearable class a few years ago. Now she's working with Dr. Esmail-Beghi on an oral trackpad device.
The idea behind this was to help individuals with upper limb disabilities to interface with computers.
It looks like a retainer, but the discrete wearable has built-in electronics that allow users to control a computer cursor.
Basically, you put this in your mouth, and you're able to use your tongue and swipe and click.
She showed us how it works. The device connects via Bluetooth to a computer or phone. Then she's ready to tap away with her tongue.
This acts just like your computer trackpad.
Wearable is definitely our future, but seamless wearable is our future. That's why in our lab, we develop discrete devices that don't attract unwanted attention. They blend into everyday life.
It's a common theme among the students in the wearable program.
It makes me feel like I'm doing something important, and that like something we're doing is like gonna help build the future and help people like save lives.
I think there's no other feeling that is more satisfying than knowing that a person is really trying to not only improve their quality of life, but as a result have a positive impact in the society that they live in.
The designers are hoping to secure funding to bring the retainer to market. There's a wearable device startup link on our website. Back to you.